Welcome back to John's Music. This time we are reviewing one of the most portable, coolest...
A little smaller amp.
Amp. The last week we reviewed the Katana
bigger,
MK2.
Bigger brother.
The bigger one. The bigger
50 one. 50 watt.
Bada bhai. Yeah. And this is the small 7 watt Katana Mini. Mini. So this doesn't have an MK2 version or something, this is just now just mini.
Yeah.
This is as light as this, including the batteries. Yeah. So it's 1.4 kilos is what they have told, including the batteries. This can be operated with an adapter as well. This is the primary funda is home practice and touring it along. If you want to just take it on, you want to just sitting at the airport, you want to just play and practice something, you know. So that's that kind of an amp. We are getting into it. First, we'll just check the rear panel,
which is
a battery just, pack.
Yeah.
Small 6 batteries. Now these batteries are provided. Not these batteries. There might be some other brand. We are not sure yet. But 6 batteries provided by the company. The adapter is not provided by Boss as of now. I think most of the pedal lines also in the Boss is not, they are, no, they are providing
adapters. They don't provide the adapters.
They don't provide adapters.
Yeah, they have like the battery included.
Right? Correct. So here the tiny input is aux input. Yeah. And here is the phone output for headphones or if you want to put it into your laptop to record as well. So 6 batteries.
That again is an emulated output. Yeah. That's an emulated output.
Yes, it's cabinet voiced, which means you're not going to get just the
raw sound.
It will be emulated as per the cabinet.
So you could still choose to have a smaller amp and you could record it with.
Correct. Now this has got a very sturdy handle, more sturdy than I could ask for.
Yeah,
now
first I
thought, why is this handle this hard? But then it also protects
the knobs.
Around them, you know. So if your amp happens to fall down this way, your knobs are still safe because these are more delicate items as compared to the other things.
Okay.
So now let's get into what is this amp offering.
Yeah.
We have a standard input, quarter inch input for your guitar. Yes,
simple
jack.
Power on switch.
Simple power on. Just there's a red light.
And there are 3 channels actually. You know, it's not like a regular practice amp. It offers only a clean and a crunch tone.
Correct.
Or a clean or a distorted tone. But
this has three options from the bigger brothers of Katana 50 and 100. So it has got a cleaner, crunch and brown.
And brown.
Just explaining key. What are the knobs? This is a gain, volume. We have the bass, mid, treble, standard EQ. And we have a delay time and the level.
Correct. Usually a lot of amps, they give you just a spring digital reverb, but this one's got a delay. So you
can actually and the time as well, so that you can control how much delay you want. So without any further ado, let's check out how this sounds. We are going to mic it with a Shure SM57 plugged in directly into an audio interface. And let's check that out. So the first... section is the clean section. Let's now this is basically by the gain is center, volume is center, whatever audio you're listening to is directly recorded on the SM57. This is placed sort of side me because speaker is actually side me, not in the center. Yeah, so this is the clean channel. So this is 50% gain and 50% volume. Let's have a higher volume and a higher gain.
That's a pretty loud amp.
Pretty loud amp for a 7 watt.
For a 7 watt.
It's good enough for a big room, like even for a 200 square feet room.
If you have like a small room where you jam along with your friends with a muted drum, I think this could easily get the job done.
Yes, you can even jam like 2 electric guitars.
Yeah.
And this should suffice. So that is the clean section. EQ section, again, it's as per taste of the guitarist. Now we are directly switching on to the crunch section. So that much is the power of this little amp.
And that's pretty much enough.
Pretty much enough. And now we are checking out the brown.
Oh.
very high gain.
It sounds good.
So even at higher volumes, it's not really crackling up to a like an irritating level. Pretty smooth.
Oh, yeah. It's got a good sustain as well.
Yes. So that is the crunch, the clean and the brown. So the effects, the amp modeling sessions are that much only. There isn't much other than that. We have to straight away jump to the FX section, which is only one delay. So this is delay level. This is a time set to 50. So this was in clean. Let's check that in crunch. A crunch.
It's on a good delay.
We'll just maximize the delay and check how's it sounding. Pretty good for a practice amp, yeah. I can say. Yeah. So this is the highest amount of time. Yeah. So it's repeating. Obviously, you don't have a tap delay section where you can tap and set the thing.
But this is pretty much enough. You know?
This is good for a practice
for you
amp,
to
yeah.
For you to dial your own lead tone. You know, right. Basically, whenever you're practicing leads,
right.
Your solos and everything, you need good amount of delay to make it sound larger.
Right.
So, and this does that.
Correct. So I think as a small amp, this should be one of the craziest
sounding
amps.
It could easily replace a lot of home amps that
a lot
of people have.
A 10-watt amp. Yeah.
10-watt amp to be very precise.
Because 7-watt is doing the job and as well as doing a portability thing. Also, the
sounds
best,
nice.
Yeah, sounds nice. And the aux input helps you to put music input and you can jam your
Backing track.
Along with the backing track,
anything like we have.
So, how about we check that as well?
Yeah.
So now we have connected the iPhone to, this has a 3.5 connector, to the amp right now. It's the whole sound is coming through the mic. I'm raising the volume right now and you can see the power of the speaker. So that was the backing track playing and the solo was that great playing, by the way. And it sounds so close to the original track as well. Yeah. Hmm. So the entire sound coming from such a small amp is the surprise, actually.
It's incredible.
So I hope whoever is looking for a practice amp, a home practice amp, as well as a travel amp, this should be one of the amps that has to be in the list. There are a couple of other brands as well, but then I think this is
something that has to offer a lot.
Yeah, there are like a lot of brands that are giving 3 watts to 5 watts, but the 7 watts just gives that extra amount and it is really
very light. It's travel friendly, in fact.
Yeah, and the batteries also last pretty long if you use a proper alkaline battery. And if you do not want to use batteries, you can use an adapter. One thing I would have loved in this amp is a chargeable function. Like now everything is a chargeable thing, like your mobile.
Yeah.
Or else basically a port that you can, basically without batteries, for example, you have a portable charger.
Correct.
And you can connect a portable charger and power this amp.
Correct.
So I hope this is one of the things that Bose can implement in the future. But
if they come up with an MK2 series.
MK2 series, maybe this is the idea that we gave.
Yeah.
So something more portable, except the batteries. But then as much as the design is and the sound is, it's really great. And so that was the review about the Bose Katana Mini. And thank you again for watching this channel. Thank you, Bala, for...
Thank you for having me here.
Yeah, for participating in our review here. And subscribe to our channel for more informative videos. And if you like our content, do share as well.
Yeah.
Till then, see you again.
Bye.